Hey, what's up, you guys? Whoa. Welcome to a map called Desertion. Yeah, so this is colorful.
Holy, yeah, the saturation's like Mongo high on this, eh?
Holy, it's not your monitor, you guys.
It's like cartoony.
There's a lot of blue going on.
Blue 22!
Blue? No. By you?
No, do we know if there's any shootables?
There's a whiskey bottle there.
FMG.
Whiskey bottle coming home.
Whiskey river, take me home.
So if you watch out, there's a hole in the roof there that they might come out of there.
Get out of here. Slice.
They all came out of there, none out of this hole that time. Oh, you opened it up. Look at you.
Why not? Take a look. There's a
shotgun.
Oh, is this shield part? Next part is a 15.
Was there a regular pistol in here? FMG9. Dude was fast.
Yeah, why is that guy all of a sudden going fast? Not cool. I know, I need to get enough so I can...
How about that FMG9?
There we go. Yep, I just got it. Oh, you can't go wrong. 36-288.
You know, out here, the sky and everything, it looks like ultra realistic, though, doesn't it?
Super, super blue.
This is what it looks like through
my eyes. Makes me want to go to a resort. Even though I don't really like resorts anymore, but still.
Okay, pistol's not even worth trying. Remember Akimbo FMG9s?
Oh, yeah.
Akimblos.
I remember that, and I also remember Akimbo 1887's cross-mapping people.
Pre-patch.
Oh my god, they were so awesome.
I told you this story, I've told everybody else too. I never used them until after the patch.
Yeah.
And because I was prestiging, right? So I never had access to them. Then finally when I got leveled out, I used them post-patch and they were still good.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they were ridiculously good, though, dude. Like,
it's just annoying.
You couldn't defeat them. They were...
Everybody got annoyed that they were getting killed across the map by a shotgun.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You mad, bro?
Like, they weren't balanced, but I just find there's too much crying of balancing this and balancing that, like, to the point where it's like they have to have every weapon...
It's an
arcade. Same as every other weapon.
Well, I know what it is. I can tell you what it is. So some people want to use a certain gun.
Yeah,
and
crappy
ones. It's not the air quote best gun in the game.
Yeah,
right?
yeah.
So what? Use it. It's an arcade video game. Who cares?
They know that they're putting themselves at a disadvantage, and then they whine because the other guns are better. I'm like, okay, well, I know you think you're cool for using a different gun, but...
Yeah. What does it matter?
It don't matter, Mike.
Oh, yeah.
Find the gun that works well with you. Yeah. And, you know, sometimes, just sometimes, you got killed because you did something stupid or the other person's better than you, and you need to just get over it.
Most people are better than me, so I don't even care.
You're like, I have no idea if it's OP or not. I'm just getting wrecked.
I'm one of those guys like, look, if I like the look of the M4 or something, I'm using it, you know?
Yeah, yeah. You just have to accept it, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I'm opening this up.
I'll get the next one. I think this has got to be open too.
Where's the power at?
There's shield.
Shield piece. There's power.
Ooh, jug.
P90 off the wall.
P90?
Yeah.
Where the hell is that?
Right here, next to the power switch.
Okay.
1400.
Dude, P90? Can't go wrong with that.
P90, you're the one. P90, you're so much fun.
It is fun. Whee!
We're in a deserted desert island.
no, no, no.
Oh! I was trying to reload that whole time. I was trying to reload.
I was like, oh no.
The reload was super real.
Speak cola leaf. Oh, I'll have one of those. Delicious.
Don't mind if I do.
Delicious.
Oh yeah.
I need the box.
Where's the box at? Boxes. Oh, is there somewhere else to go?
Yeah, there's the side. The
oh, okay.
Side
I was gonna
there.
Say. I thought maybe we found the only place to go. We'll go to the box next, friend.
Yeah, so I can use my crate power.
That's great.
Did you get speed or double first?
I bought speed first.
Well, I'm just gonna open this because...
What is this? 74U?
Ah! Horrible.
What'd you get?
Oh, dude, did they go... No, I didn't get any. It's a bazooka. I bet you that truck over there is the ending. I like okay. How colorful this is.
Yeah, it's pretty fun.
This looks great.
Run out of ammo here.
Yeah, what the heck? What is up with that? Oh, what? Damn it. I don't even... Did you see me stepping on that?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't even see it. What at?
Afterburner.
Come on, baby!
What'd you get?
I don't care, I'm doing it.
Oh, we're just talking about the models.
Yeah.
We're just talking about the models, man.
They're akimbos.
Akimblos? Yeah, it's because they're packed, right? Oh, you're just going in hard.
Yeah, hard. Because I'm alternating them. They're working out really well. I gotta get those doubles. Uh-oh. Looks like I gotta reload them. Fun time's over, baby.
Whoop.
Dude. The root beer float. Are you stupid, partner?
Are you stupid? Pack punch around the corner, maybe?
I shouldn't have got that because I could have just got the gobble and got my perk-aholic.
You're a holic.
A holic. I would not make a very good alcoholic anyway. As I get wicked hangovers, and I would just be barfing all the time.
Double points.
Doesn't agree with me. I get motion sickness.
Vertigo.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know if I don't get vertigo. Vertigo.
Remember
when
you got sick in the Jeep going up the hill and Can We Survive?
Oh, yeah.
It was one of those windy mountain roads, you guys. We pulled over once, you're like, no, I'm good. Then you're like, dude, you gotta pull over. It's because you had McDonald's that morning.
It was, I mean, I've had McDonald's before, but...
Yeah, but when you combine it with mountain driving, not so good.
Yeah, plus I was fresh off the plane, and I find always whenever I'm fresh off the plane...
Yeah.
That's a problem.
You think there's a buyable, you might want to open this one.
Yeah, because whenever I'm fresh off the plane... Oh! 50,000.
Pack-a-punch here in this little shed. You think that's music, those teddies? Because there's one on the bench here.
Probably. Did you shoot that thing already?
You did.
Oh, I thought... Because it didn't make a noise, that's why I figured you might have.
We Where's the P90 at? Oh.
I gotta get the, gobbles. Gobbles! Oh, yeah. We make our own sausage and egg McMuffins now in our house.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I get the pre-made sausage patties that are pre-cooked. We just crack an egg, get the English muffins. Hey, where's that gobblegum? There it is.
Where's the gobblegum?
What you got for me, gobblegum? Wrong one. Extra credit. Son of a nut. I'll give that to you, though. We're going to have to be here for a little bit. Get those points.
Get them points.
Them points, them points, them beef points. Does that even make sense?
Yep. To me, it does. Yeah.
It sure does. Come on. Oh, yeah, I remember that. I remember that ride up there. I was like, oh, Jesus, things are not going. I'm not feeling so good. Yeah, it was right after I ate that sandwich, too.
Yeah.
The old body was like, nope. Here.
Hook me up with the credits.
You're doing that. That's not weird. There. What's the last one? That's all I got, friend. I need speed.
Speed demon. Using the FMG right now.
Why not?
Ooh, doubles. I'll do my extra credits now with doubles.
Oh, is that? Yeah, you got extra credits now too?
Yeah.
Here, let me hit those guys.
Extra credit during double is 2,500, man. FMG is still putting in work, dude.
It's a workhorse.
I remember it having low ammo. This one's got good ammo.
Wall power.
Wall power?
You don't want any wall power.
Shopping free. Oh, hey, let's go to Pack-a-Punch.
Okay.
Cover me.
Coming. Yeah, I'm coming. Did you see any other decent wall weapons?
Nah. I thought if I got wall, I'd probably get the 74U or something like that.
Yeah. I'm like, well...
Has been through the egg, get yourself something nice.
Cover me.
Dead wire on the P90.
There you go, I got you some time. Time!
Dead wire on the afterburner.
Yes, oh my god, yes it is!
And turned. On this guy.
Yeah, don't kill the lot. Oh shoot.
Sorry. I didn't kill him actually. Like,
no, that's true.
Theoretically, that guy did.
Theoretically, you didn't kill any of them because they're undead.
True.
How about that for a little reality check, Mister?
Collapse and crusher. Oh, he just got crushed.
Ooh, that's nice. It's so weird when you go in the water, there's like a graphical anomaly glitch.
Yeah, your
I can see my shotgun. Yeah.
Oh, it goes from akimbo to single when you go underwater too, if you have akimbo.
Yeah. Kill them all!
Dang, these got a lot of bullets.
the FMG.
Yeah, the P90 has got the EOTech on it. It's got it on the top of the handle. In real life, this is what happens. You got to put a very, very small red dot on the P90 because it looks goofy like this IRL. Well, that's
the M16 looks goofy. They put it on that top
carry handle. Yeah. Well, after like,
that looks ridiculous.
1980 was the M16A1, which still had the fixed carry handle. After that, when they went to the M4, they got the flat top receiver, Picatinny style, to where you could put whatever you wanted on there. You take off the handle.
Yeah, totally.
What he said.
I don't understand why they even thought of putting a carry handle on there. Who the hell walks around carrying it like it's a piece of luggage? I don't know anyone. Not when I was in the military, not ever. I've never seen anyone carry it like that.
Well, because back in the day, they didn't have red dots, right? So yeah. It was a way to put the rear sight up at the right height.
Yeah, I guess so. And here's a handle you'll never use.
I've seen some old Vietnam movies where they show the guy using the carry handle.
Oh, yeah.
But most of them do carry like I do, which is right in front of the magazine holding onto the barrel.
Yeah.
Because it's the most balanced point.
Well, you're going to sling it. You're just walking.
Yeah.
You're going to sling it. I'm putting in the shoulder strap on. I'm not carrying the top handle.
Sling it real good, man.
Yo.
Oh, colorful.
Dun, 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 dun,
look at
dun,
you
dun,
with your dun, shotguns. Insta-kill.
This.
What are you shooting, the cactus?
Bench. Bucket.
It's
zombie.
Bench bucket.
Let's see what happens here. Oh, yeah. Animation's all messed up in here.
Yeah. You get all glitchy.
It's a visual anomaly. I get out of here. What the? Someone touch me?
Touch me now. Oh, I shocked the water. Shock the water. Ooh.
Booyah.
Do bless.
Double points.
Get it. Get it good. Get it real good. Booyah, booyah, booyah.
Booyah. Eat lead, zombies.
Punch your fist into the air. Shake it around like it doesn't know. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Would you pack P90?
The Pananda.
You see how high that EOTech is up
there?
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, yeah.
If you use like a traditional little barrel-style red dot, they have a kit where where it mounts lowers down inside that handle about an inch, and so it barely sticks up. It's way better, but it's an aftermarket part.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not like from FN.
What's funny is in Cold War 2, when you're putting stuff like this on some of the weapons, like M16, same thing. It's on top of the carry handle. Looks funny and balls, but that's the way you would have done it.
That was 1980, right? There was no... Yeah. They had carry handles.
That's what they do. They throw it on top here, just like you would. So at least they're staying true to it, right? They're not making it just look cool.
Yeah. Kaboom. Yeah, I find it interesting because I like history. You know, I like that. And seeing, like, their clothes and all the stuff, you know, the guns, the clothes, and the campaign, it's really solid. A lot of East and West Berlin stuff, some stuff in the Ural Mountains in Ukraine, and just a lot of neat stuff in the campaign. It's pretty good.
How does the campaign look, though? Because you know how I find the multiplayer maps look phenomenal.
It's
I
good.
Love the detail. I love the detail in the maps.
No,
really
it's really good.
Good,
but they also try and do more of a cinematic thing, so you get that kind of 24p effect.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So it's a bit more cinematic. But the interesting thing is, when they had like a briefing with the CIA, and this like, I said it when I was playing, I'm like, this is when the CIA were badasses. Like, they were taking no prisoners.
These guys
were out there with their bandanas on and just killing fools, right?
Yeah.
None
yeah.
of this computer malarkey.
Well, not just that now, too, though. Nowadays, half that stuff doesn't happen because everyone's got a damn cell phone and everyone's soldiers are held account. You killed that person. I'm like, you do realize they're soldiers, right?
Right. Like, so they had a briefing with the CIA and the president, and it was Ronald Reagan, and it totally looked like him. Like they, they're doing a really good job with the models,
CGI
and it's different. And like Ubisoft tries to go over realistic, like with the NVIDIA hair model and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it ends up looking stringy. These guys didn't do that, but their face and their skin looks really good texture wise.
It's on point.
It
is. You can see the pores and stuff.
Oh, yeah. And the one guy's got scars all over his face. And, Mason is in there. And I'm like, wait a
minute.
Yeah. Mason, isn't he from one of the other Black Ops later on? So Mason is.
Mason was from Black Ops, the original.
That's what I mean. Yeah. But he's like a second or third. You play as Mason a little bit, but.
Oh, okay.
You play as Bell. I call him Meaty. And I made him. You can make him whatever he is, like his dossier.
Yeah.
So I'm an ex-KGB agent working for the CIA, and my name is Meaty, but my code name is Bell.
Yeah, the Bell of the Ball.
So it's pretty good, but it's a little short for my
taking.
Yeah,
I heard it was short.
Yeah, I got through it pretty quick. It's only 9 missions, and they flow right into each other. And then there's 2 side missions, and wow, it took me like 5 minutes. But the side missions, what they did was, is kind of cool, I guess. They made you have to collect evidence throughout the other missions, and then once you had the evidence, you had to actually do the stuff that you like to do, is deciphering code, like logic code.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
So one was 16, 20, 26. You know, it's like, okay, what makes these things different, right? And you had to fill in the blank on one of them. And then there was another one where I had to start from the other side. And it went 4, 3, 2, 1 was the difference between the numbers.
Oh, okay.
And so, yeah, it was pretty cool. And then there was some where it's like you had to figure out. You looked at their ledger to see where they were on what dates. Then you cross-referenced who was there. And then it did a city. And it was neat. Took me a second to do it. Then I got into the side mission. It was like 5 minutes. I cleared like a desert motel and I was done. Like what?
And done.
What? What was that? But I like it. It's really like graphically, I would say, yeah. Like, the first episode I got was chasing down this AC-130 in a Jeep. And I threw an RC car on the ground. And the RC car, I had to drive it up and blow up the landing gear as it was trying to take off, and it was like, wow, that was really neat looking.
You have ray tracing. You have an RTX card, though, don't
yes.
you?
Yes. Yeah,
I
ray tracing,
so.
Yes, sir. So it looks really good.